sentences to imperatives. Exercise 4. I will do a couple of examples. There, they were told to open their books. They were told to open their books. That is a statement. Make it imperative. The imperative is open the books. Open the books. That is imperative. You are requested to help the poor. Please help the poor. So the remaining exercises you should do yourself. Now interrogative sentences. Sentences that ask questions are called interrogative sentences. An interrogative sentence ends with a question mark. Interrogative sentences may also be negative. So sentences that ask questions are called interrogative sentences. An interrogative sentence ends with a question mark. Interrogative sentences may also be negative. Where are you going? Why did you turn off the music? Hasn't the train arrived yet? So these are the examples of interrogative sentences. Two sentences are positive, affirmative, one is negative. The formation of interrogative sentence. Look at the sentence. Tina is a dancer. Is Tina a dancer? The first statement is assertive, while the second one is a question or an interrogative sentence. Is Tina a dancer? To form the interrogative or question, we change the position of the subject and the verb so that the subject Tina comes after the verb. Very important. To form an interrogative sentence from a statement, you have to change the word order. The verb comes first, then subject comes after the verb. Tina is a dancer. Here subject is Tina, but when you make a question, what comes first? Is comes first and Tina, the subject, comes next. So this is the way of making statement into interrogative sentence. If the verb in the sentence is present tense singular, we use does in the beginning to make interrogative, plural do. Example, he comes early. He comes early. The statement question is, does he come early? Does he come early? Because in the sentence, he comes early, the verb is comes, present tense singular. So you have to use, to make it interrogative, you have to use the auxiliary does. They play well. They play well. Statement, negative question, and the question is, do they play well? Do they play well? Because subject is plural. If the subject is past tense, we have to use the auxiliary did or helping verb did in the beginning of the sentence. He went to Rajakot yesterday. He went to Rajakot yesterday. Did he go to Rajakot yesterday? Did he go to Rajakot yesterday? So you can read the text. You can understand more about this. Okay, I shall read for you. In us, time. The assertive sentences that have helping, also auxiliary verbs like is, am, are, have, has, had, where, was, the question starts with a helping verb. Similarly, in sentences that have words like can, may, will, should, etc., also called modal auxiliaries, the question starts with a modal auxiliary. Examples: Prabhu is eating an apple. Is Prabhu eating an apple? I have 10 rupees. Have you 10 rupees? There are 5 apples in the basket. Are there 5 apples in the basket? Chimbu has eaten all the cake. Has Chimbu eaten all the cake? Rahil should join the coaching class. Should Rahil join the coaching class? They will call later. Will they call later? So, all these examples, the auxiliary verb is used the beginning of the interrogative sentence. Is, have, are, has, should, will. So, when forming questions from assertive sentences that do not have helping verbs, that I already told you, I already said the beginning of the class, the helping verb do is used in the beginning of the question. Salary sings well. Here verb sings, singular, so does Shalini sing well? If it is plural, you have to use, subject is plural, you have to use do. In such sentences, the helping verb changes according to person, number or tense, while the main verb remains as its base verb. This is important thing. In such sentences, that is, the sentences do not have auxiliary verb, we use modal auxiliaries to make question. The helping verb changes according to person. If it is singular, does, plural, do. But be careful, after modal auxiliaries, the main verb will be always base form of the verb. Here, Shalini sings well. Here, sings, the S is taken out when we use does. But the verb is singular. But since we use does here, we have to use base form. I told you what is the base. Base form means write, wrote, written. These are three forms of the verb. Write present tense, wrote past tense, written past participle. For write is the base form. To make it singular, we use yes, writes, then that base form becomes singular. If you remove yes, that base form becomes plural. That is important. In such the examples, Mr. Rao went to the market. Here, look at went is the verb, that is past tense. So we use did. Did Mr. Rao, when is the base form, when is go. So did Mr. Rao go to the market? Very careful. It is wrong if you say did Mr. Rao went to the market, it is wrong. You change went into go. That is the base form. This machine makes coffee. Makes is a verb, singular. So does this machine make? Remove the ES, coffee. We watch a movie every Saturday. Watch, plural, verb. So do we watch a movie every Saturday? Now form interrogative sentences from the following assertive sentences. So, couple of sentences I can do. Geeta can dance very well. Can Geeta dance very well? They have won the match. Have they won the match? This is a good book. Is this a good book? So the remain, you have to do the remain exercises. Now to change the following interrogative sentences into assertive sentences. Exercise. Does a cow live on grass? What is the assertive sentence? A cow lives on grass. Are you feeling better today? Are you feeling better today? I am feeling better today. That is assertive. Shall I help you? You shall. I shall help you. Mustn't you work hard now? You must not. You must work hard now. Do I hate lies? I hate lies. These are the answers. Now, exclamatory sentences. Sentences that express strong feelings are called exclamatory sentences. An exclamation mark is used at the end of an exclamatory sentence. Alas, I am undone. It is sorrow. To express sorrow, we had used alas. Hooray, India has won the match. To express joy, we use hooray. What a horrible death. Horror. Beware. He is going to hit you. Warning. Oh dear, you are hurt. Concern. What a pleasant surprise. That is surprise. Now rewrite the following statements into exclamations. I have committed a blunder. So I will do this example for you. Alas, I have committed a blunder. It is a beautiful day. What a beautiful day it is. I hope God bless you. May God bless you. It is sad he could not make it on the top of Mount Everest. Alas, I could not make it to the top of Mount Everest. The Taj is beautiful. How beautiful the Taj is. Now, exercise 8. Classify the following sentences that you have to do by yourself. Whether which is assertive, which is imperative, which is interrogative, which is exclamatory. You have to find out. There are 10 examples are given. Ten questions are given. You have to find out. Okay, this is about the sentence. Please, you can look at the book and try to find out or understand. If you have any problem, you can call me. So my number is 7874385114. 7834 85